So overnight, the U.S. passed more than 2 million confirmed cases of coronavirus. One key model is now showing a potentially devastating resurgence in cases in the fall. One expert now says we could see 100,000 new deaths by September. Alabama is among 18 states at this point seeing an increase in new cases over the past week. In fact, the average rate of infections has really not dropped there in weeks. Joining me now, Montgomery Mayor Stephen Ree. He's the first African-American mayor in a city known as the birthplace of the civil rights movement. We'll get to that in a moment. First, though, on the pandemic, Mayor, I've been looking at the daily confirmed new cases in Montgomery County, Alabama, over the last few weeks, and really just no drop at all. In some cases, a little bit of a rise over the last week. Why?
I think it's because we opened up too soon. I think that we have COVID fatigue right now, and people are trying to fast forward this process in order to get things back to the way they were before the COVID-19 pandemic really changed everything in this country, if not the world.
There was one picture, I think, that may illustrate a little bit of what you're saying. It's Vice President Mike Pence, who's in charge of the coronavirus task force. He tweeted out a picture of him visiting the Trump campaign headquarters. I think we have that picture. And he's surrounded by a crowd of people not wearing masks, not in any way social distancing. Is this what you mean by opening up too early and rushing things?
Absolutely. I think that much of the community has taken their cues from the top, and they believe that if the president, vice president are not wearing masks, then why should they? Unfortunately, it's become a political football as well. And that has really stymied our progress in this battle with COVID-19. And so what you have is you have people who believe that the virus can be deadly. You have people that are wearing their masks when they're out in public. And you have many people who are staying at home. You have people that are practicing social distancing. But on the other side, you have people that are asymptomatic or just don't believe they are going to be impacted by the virus who are not. And that is a major problem, and that's behind part of the spike that we've seen.
The statistic that concerns me most today is that hospitalizations are up in a number of states, 9 states. One of the reasons new case numbers have gone up in some places is we're seeing more testing, which is actually a good thing. More testing will identify more cases, many of them asymptomatic. But hospitalizations, that's not about people who are asymptomatic. That's about sick people. So in these states that are red here, not Alabama, but nearby Mississippi, you also have North Carolina, South Carolina, the number of hospitalizations are going up. People are getting sick, Mayor.
Well, they are, and they're getting sick right here in Montgomery County. And what we're seeing is a rush to get back to things. And what we're trying to do is just trying to keep people patient. And I understand we've been in this since March, and people are ready to get back as they see other communities and other parts of the nation open up. But we aren't there yet, and that's why we're still under a curfew here that we instituted back in March to try to slow the spread of COVID-19. And we are really trying to work with our small business owners and work with our community members to educate them and inform them about where we are in this process. Montgomery should not be 10% of Alabama's total cases. We should not have the level of cases that we've had spike month over month and week over week when we look at our numbers. So there's still a problem here. And again, we have not factored in all of the post-Memorial Day testing that will come in and what those results will show us. So there's a lot of work that we have to do, not only in Montgomery, but the state of Alabama, but also I think throughout this country. And as infectious disease experts have warned us before, we cannot decide when this is over. The virus will decide that. And we have to make sure that we're doing everything that we can as leaders to inform our public of where we are with our hospital beds. As in Montgomery, where only 2% of our ICU beds are available, that's problematic. It's manageable, but it's not sustainable.
And look, and as you said, we don't know the effect that the protests will have when there were a lot of people out near each other, not necessarily wearing masks. We haven't seen those numbers yet. That could increase things even more. About the subject they were protesting, you've just signed on to the 8 Can't Wait prescription, which is a number of proposals to address policing now, including banning chokeholds and other things of the like. So what do you hope this accomplishes?
I hope this is the first of many steps that we have to take in order to correct policing in all of our cities and all of our communities, but in particular as it relates to people of color and black men and women particularly. We have to teach the history of policing in our communities. And I think if we're willing to open things up and open up the files, we'll see a record that's been there prior to George Floyd and Breonna Taylor and Ahmaud Arbery. We'll see a record that's been there for decades, if not longer than that. And we have to make sure that as we're having the conversations, we're also taking action and we're taking those steps as policymakers. And one of the things that our protesters wanted to see us do was they wanted to see us make changes right now, and that was the first of many. We will be instituting a citizens review board, and we want to make sure it's one that has teeth and one that gives the citizens of this community confidence, not only in our police department, but in how we train and how we operate here in Montgomery, Alabama.
Some people note that Minneapolis had actually instituted a number of those things on the eight can't wait list already, but that didn't stop the killing of George Floyd. So what do you say to people who say, this isn't enough, we need more right now?
Well, we have to really drill down into the history of systemic racism in this country, period. It's not just in policing, it's in our criminal justice system, it's in our legal system. We have to look at that as it impacts our educational system, as it impacts the economic divide as well. So we have to make sure that we are talking about this from a macro level, but certainly as it relates to mayors and police chiefs, we have to make sure that we aren't just getting people who want to be police, who want to carry a badge and a gun, that aren't psychologically prepared to be guardians of the community, who want to be policemen of the community. What I mean by that is they want to use force. They want to use the tactics and the weight they have as the police department as a weapon. Those are people we have to try to root out. We have to make sure that our reviews are very fair, very regular, and we have to make sure that we're taking action when someone does something on the force while also training our police officers, I believe, in a much different way. So they're right. There is no one step or one silver bullet for this. There's no panacea other than for us to get in and do the work consistently and be willing to adapt and adjust as we see issues arise.
Mayor Stephen Reed, thanks for coming on this morning. A lot to discuss, obviously. Appreciate it.
Always a pleasure.